So, Mel, how did you get the shape from this watermelon?
Well, first we chose a nice round melon.
Then we cut out the base just to make sure it doesn't roll around. Just a little slit to make it still, see? Doesn't move.
Then marked out a mouth and cut it at angles really carefully.
Did you use a small knife or a big knife?
Just a small one.
Okay, so just a nice
one. It's very manageable. So you cut that piece out so you get a nice mouth area. And we're going to put some pips in there made of cardboard in a second. Then carefully cut out this area and clean it up.
Was it hard to cut?
No, you just have to be slow and
slow,
careful.
Slow, yeah, alright.
Then emptied him out.
Melon baller.
There you go. And here are all the bits, which we'll put back into
the watermelon.
Watermelon.
Alright. We've got a few other pieces to make this watermelophant, which we'll discuss a bit later as we go on. Okay. So now we're going to
attach the eyes. So
you're going to use glue?
I'm thinking I'll use glue.
Yeah, just use PVA glue. Of course, try not to get this on the food. Or you could probably use toothpicks or anything similar, but seeing this as a centerpiece, it doesn't really matter. Creatively looks better. There you go.
Maybe I put this edge one. This goes in here.
Then I've washed these leaves. They're from plastic flowers that you can buy from the reject shop.
It's alright, just leave it. Yeah.
Daddy, you have not like got seven.
Okay, so the ears were too big, so we decided to cut them down to size and just have to cut it a little bit smaller than the leaf was. And what I did was put a hole. I made a hole in the watermelon with a skewer. And then I just pushed it in like this. Bent this leaf a bit because it's made. Now the nose, I got two pieces of dark green napkin and I just rolled them. I put some pins on it. I don't know if you can see. There's a pin there. Whoa, big finger. There's a pin there and I've pinned one on the other side as well. Also, what I have done just to keep it still is to put a skewer through the middle and I've just wrapped it. I've wrapped the skewer and where it turns, where it bends like this, I've slightly bent the skewer, just snapped it a little bit, put some glue and Blutak all along, and I've wrapped this napkin around. And here, down here, really is, there's nothing, there's no support joints there. It's just gravity doing the work for me. And it's mostly just, And so now all we have to do is put the melon balls back in. And then we've got our watermelophant almost done. We also have to put the pips on its mouth. So they're kind of like the teeth, which was really cool. And all these pips are, they're not actually real pips, just pieces of black cardboard that we've used. You don't have to be entirely uniform. But yeah, that's good. That's great. Fantastic. Alright. I just realized that he has a little leaf on the end of his trunk. So what I did was just cut a tiny leaf out with pretty much one of these fake flower things. I've just been pulling them on and off. And the tail, I kind of ran out of green napkin, but luckily, this one has a little bit of a stump, this watermelon, so I'm going to use that. I've stabbed a bit of a half toothpick in there. I'm going to put a little bit of glue tack on there. And I've cut out a tiny little leaf. Just kind of like that. Once you've done with the watermelophant, you can take out your scooped melons and you can put them back in to the melophant's head, like he's had a lobotomy. Anyway, if you were smart enough, you would have kept the lid, which we didn't. And you can kind of put his head back on because he also has a little bit of alfalfa coming out of the top of his head as hair. So yeah, you can display this as a centerpiece for your party, and the kids can just grab the watermelon from there, or you can serve it from his head, and it's gonna be a great little centerpiece. Enjoy!